Hi, this is Kelly. I've recently gotten the new Silhouette Curio, and it is a pretty fun machine. First of all, today I just want to show you the stippling function. This is not something that I initially thought I would use very much, but since I've tried it, it's really pretty fun. So I just want to show you basically how to use it. So once you have your Silhouette Curio connected, you will be able to access these stippling and embossing options. Okay, so a stipple, I'll just show you quickly. If you take any shape, stipple edge is going to turn the edge into a stipple. You've also got a stipple fill, so you can change what's inside. You can fill that shape with different fill patterns. And you can fill it with different designs, which is kind of fun to play with. Okay, but what I really want to show you, oh, and you do have ways to adjust it. Stipple size, I believe, is probably whether you're using a marker or a pen. So it's kind of like changing your line width. And you also, generally, it won't print your stipple. It's going to be cut for you or go through the motions of cutting, but using a marker or a pen. But you do have the option here to print it if you would rather print your piece of art that you've designed instead. Okay, so I'm going to turn all those off and delete that shape. What I want to show you is the stipple trace. Okay, so this means you can take a photograph or something and trace it and turn it into stipple art. So I have got an image here. I'm just going to drag it over from my folder that I have it saved on. You can see that this one is a pretty high resolution picture. I'm just going to select it, go to my scale window, and I'm going to lock the aspect ratio, and I don't want this to be higher than 5 inches. So I'm going to choose 5 for the height and apply. And now it's a much more reasonable size. It fits on my Curio mat. Okay, so if you have cut out a piece of paper that you're going to fill this whole small mat with, that's 8.5 inches by 6 inches. And if you're going to, if you're interested in framing this or something, I actually like to center it to the whole page in my align window. Okay, but let's get to stippling. Just like a normal trace, if you've used the trace function very much, you have to first select your area that you want to transform. So you're going to stipple, select this stipple area, just drag a box. Okay, and I have decided that I like my density at 100%. I like my refinement maximized all the way up to 4%, and I like my grid spacing to be all the way down as small as possible. So if I just use my sliders, that puts my density at 100, my refinement at 4, and my grid spacing at 0.020 inches. Okay, so that gives me some good shading, and I like it. So I'm going to click Create Stipple. Okay, so now I've got a stipple image, and it doesn't matter whether I leave this original background photo there or not. It's only going to, if you're just using your marker to stipple it, it only needs these dots. And so here it is basically ready to send to the Curio. But I want to show you what else you can do. Again, I just dragged this photograph in. This is a photograph that I edited in Photoshop, so I resized it to 5x7. Oops, I need to select it. I'm going to make my height 7 inches. So I resize this in Photoshop, and I turned it black and white. It was a color photograph. I turned it black and white because the key with stippling is to have a lot of contrast in your photograph. So I tried to make it pretty good with lights and darks. Okay, I'm just going to take this first, go to my stipple trace, select stipple area, and I'm just going to drag my box around it. And that's its first choice it's going to give me. Okay, so I want my density at 100, move the refinement up to 4, and grid spacing to 0.20. Okay, now you've got some other options. These will just slightly change how it looks. So you've got simple, exact, simple, abstract, regular 1 through 7, and then white noise, a couple of white noise, and 3 or 4 dot matrix. You can play with those. I'm going to show you for this photograph. Okay, so this is, I'm just going to play with the regular 1 through 7. This is regular 1. And this has been different, what I've chosen for each photograph that I've tried. Regular 7 is okay. So you can see it's just changing a little bit. And what I'm watching on this photo is the eyes. I want the eyes to have that little catch light. And of course, it's all just a bunch of dots. So the closer or farther you are away is going to make a difference on how you perceive it. Okay, so that's what I get with regular 5 when I do the stipple trace horizontally. I'm going to create my stipple. Alright, and I'm actually going to move this off to the side for a minute. And I want to show you what happens when I rotate this so it fits on my page horizontally, the way I'm going to end up running it through the machine. Okay, so centered it to the page, back to stipple, select stipple area. I'm going to do the exact same thing as I did before. I want density 100, refinement 4, grid spacing 0.20, and what did we do? We did regular 5. Okay, so I'm going to show you the difference between these two photographs. So I used the exact same settings. The difference was the direction it was laying when I traced it. So you can see that it's going to interpret what it wants you to trace a little differently. So they're pretty close. It's the background and the edges that are different. Okay, but for now, let's see this in action. The other thing I should point out here is that if I had chosen an image that had a shadow on the bottom, that looks good in a photograph, but I specifically chose this one without a shadow because it will stipple trace a shadow for that too, and that gets rid of the nice clean outline of the shape and makes it a little confusing if you don't know why that extra blob is there when it's really a shadow, because it's just looking for light and dark. So if you go to the cut settings window, you'll get this normal view where you see the bold red for what it's going to cut, and in this case draw. So with my Curio, I'm going to put my pen in the tool 1, which is the left hand pen holder, and I'm going to tell it that it's a sketch pen even though it's going to be actually a Sharpie marker. But that'll give me maximum speed. And I'm just going to leave my thickness at 18. Now this is different with the platforms. With the Curio, you need to assemble your platforms in the order and the number that it tells you. So it wants a total of 6. So 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 is 6. I'm going to get 2 of my number 2 platforms and 1 number 1 platform, and then my cutting platform. And this one's going to be the cutting mat. And I will show you that in a second. And once I get that loaded, I'll just click send to silhouette and you can watch it draw. Here's the silhouette Curio machine. And this is the standard base that comes with the Curio. These are the platforms to get the top surface to the correct depth. Each of these platforms is labeled with a 2 or a 1, and you get all of the ones you need that comes with the machine. The platform numbers are referred to in the material settings on the cut settings window. These platforms have holes that fit into the base with small clips to hold the stack in place. So just line the notches up with the holes and put those clips down to hold them. Now I'll take off the cover from the cutting mat and I'll put my cardstock on the sticky mat that I've trimmed down to fit exactly. So it's 8.5 inches by 6 inches, so I can stipple on it. Now you can slide the base in while the machine is off. Just push it in so the notch here on the side, there's one on each side, it just needs to be further in than the front of the machine. Then you turn on the Curio and it will find its correct position. Now Silhouette has stipple markers, but here I'm just using a Sharpie ultra-fine marker and the Silhouette adjustable pen holder with the largest collet. It's the gray one. And I've done this a few times, so I'm just sliding my pen in and just eyeballing it. It goes in pretty far, and it's kind of hard to mess up. It's just making dots, so. Here you can see about how far I've pushed mine in. And you can experiment with it and just do some trial and error. So in Studio, I set my cut settings to use the left blade holder, and that's the one marked with a red circle, and so that's where I'm placing my marker. I always scribble a little bit on scratch paper immediately before cutting. So here I pressed the send to silhouette button in the software, and you can watch it go. And stippling an image does take a while, so I'm going to speed this up for you. I usually get this going before I do some larger thing, household chores, making dinner, helping kids with homework. I just let my machine run while it's doing the stippling. And then I can come back and watch it when it's finished. This apple took maybe about 25 minutes to do the whole thing. And here it is finished. Just press the unload button on the side of the machine and pull out the base. And there you go. You've got a Stipple art apple that's ready to frame.